make a video with some good news, and I've been waiting, trying to find some good news. But I recall back 15 years ago when the future was laid out for me in that visionary dream, and I saw the collapse of fiat currency taking place. I was really inconsolable over that. It was just a terrible, terrible crash. So we're talking about something that is beyond serious, really. So it's difficult to even talk about this. We can be philosophical about it, but that's not really good enough. The truth is that existence is scripted, okay? It really is. We think that it's all subject to all sorts of influences, etc. Well, it may seem that way, but it's scripted that way. It's scripted to look like we have meaningful choices, but it's not true. The whole thing is scripted and predestined, unfortunately. It's like the script is scripted in such a way it makes us believe and think that we can influence what's going on and change things, that we have the power to do this. But that's just a sucker us in and trick us into maintaining a fixation with what's going on, thinking that we have the power to change it. Well, we really don't. It's all scripted in a certain way by mind. So you could say that the things that are going to happen are fated to happen. They will happen because they have been scripted that way by that which is in control of existence. Now that's the bad news. The good news is that it's not God the Prime Creator that's in control of existence. God the Prime Creator is in control of reality, and reality is still there as an option for you. So it's bad news, good news. The bad news is existence continually will play us for fools and bring massive misery to us. The good news is that we can set existence down, because it's really just an idea that we had, and we can pick up and choose another idea. And this is explained in great clarity and detail over at my other channel, Christ Clarity. Now, as far as what's taking place right now, everything is taking place exactly as scripted. The people involved in the financial markets are beginning to get the jitters, a severe case of jitters. You're seeing that taking place now. The market's very unstable. It plunged down today, and then the very last, just before it closed, it shot back up because investors are jittery. They're desperately trying to deny the fear that they have. It's kind of like the kind of courage, defiance in the face of severe adversity. You get into a situation where you simply become defiant and say, I'm not afraid of all those bullets flying. It's that kind of reaction. So initially, when they were clear-headed enough, they drove the market way down, okay, into a bear market, realizing, you know, this is the smart thing to do. And then they lost their nerve and they said, whoa, wait a minute. We don't dare go there. We can't lose faith in the market. We've got to keep our faith in the market. And so they drove it back up again. These wild swings that you're seeing now are what is going to take place here leading up to the latter part of October. And then sometime in the late part of October, October 27th, 28th, around there, you will see then at some point a loss of nerve. You will see at that point a feeling that something drastic is on the horizon. It's kind of like you're in a big ship and you see an iceberg up ahead and you go, uh-oh, you know, we're in trouble. Something is looming on the horizon that we realize that we're in drastic trouble now. That's a different thing. Right now, there's just jitters going on, a feeling like yes, no, yes, no, yes, no. At some point, it will just be yes. There's a drastic problem, and then the mood will change at that point, and that will lead us into November. The entire mood of the world will certainly be affected, especially by those who are most intelligent, most sensitive, most aware, those are the ones that are really going to feel it so strongly. But paradoxically, those are the ones who are going to seek true remedies most quickly. Now, I know that there is a kind of a belief going around that at the end of October, October 28th, something tremendous is going to happen. I also am saying that, yes, something tremendous is going to happen. But what I also say is it's not going to be the resolution or the fixing of the financial problems at all. All of those are going to still take place, and the collapse is going to take place. It's all going to be very terrible, that. But there will be something tremendous, a tremendous option that those who are most aware are going to be able to tune into at that time. This will be prior to the collapse. I'm saying the collapse will happen probably late November, probably at the earliest. But that something tremendous is going to happen on October 28th, that around that time, for those who are most keenly aware and understanding that a collapse is coming and that a remedy must be found, and this is very serious, they are going to be able to tune into something at that time which will be like a life preserver for them. So probably the best that we can do right now is to promote the idea, the concept, the belief that October 28th, that's a good date to take, is something tremendous will happen. Put your expectations on that. Believe that. Don't spend too much time worrying about the market, because that is a fait accompli. It is going to happen. The troubles are going to come. It's like a massive storm coming in. You know the storm will come in. It's not in question. The question is, though, where can you place yourself so that you're not in harm's way? So as much as possible, try talking up this date of October 28th and saying, let us believe that a lifeline will appear at that time for us. Spread this around. Get the expectations going. Start building your expectations. It's like a bridge out of troubled waters. It's very important. So what we can do is we can share favorite videos that highlight October 28th as a lifeline date. Share those videos, post them on Facebook, favorite them, let your friends know about them. Start building this wave right now. Don't wait. It's time to do that. Start building this wave of positive expectations. And probably emphasize that over all the bad news, because we know about the bad news. It's all taking place for sure. It's like a train wreck in slow motion. We don't need to pay too much attention to that. A little bit's fine, but it's better to put our time into building positive expectations for this date. Okay. Best of luck at doing that, and I'll keep doing what I can do on this.